Okay. Now, I'm gonna show you a little bit of the local food here. This is the bridge that I always cross. They're building another bridge here. Unfortunately, there's some kind of building going on, so they're building another bridge here. You can go to the sea, it's right there. And I'm trying to hold umbrella while I'm walking, and this is like it's snowing sideways, that my camera is gonna get all wet from the little bit of snowing. And you can see that over there there's like half melted yard here, but this is basically a horse ranch that's stopped by that kind of like a river kind of thing. And holy shit, man. But anyway, you can see a sign like that you're not supposed to drive the horses to this place that I'm going. Kind of rare sight, but it's because you're not supposed to summon your epic mounts here. You might get a speed post. My camera is... I'm really suffering right now. I can see that the snow is just all over this fucking thing. But anyway, now it's a pretty good weather outside, so I decided to show a little bit of the countryside here. So there's a lot of snow. Last time that I was filming this kind of stuff was in the winter, I mean Christmas day. But now I'm doing a little bit of WTF vlog. So you can see that there's a lot of snow. My feet are all covered in snow. Yeah, you can play with this and build stuff with it. And I usually go take a little bit of leak behind that electric building in there. But anyway, this is kind of like a place that you can... It looks like it's like a total snow jungle in there. There's a lot of snow that you're actually gonna sink into this place. And I used to, in the summertime especially, I used to walk around this place. Because it's kind of like a walking path. You're not supposed to drive any kind of vehicles here. And then you can also, it looks really good on the, you can see different kind of birds around this place. And it's surrounded by water, so you don't want to go close to that, because I'm going to slip in there and then I'm going to be swimming in that mud river in there. But that other side of this river is basically a horse ranch on summertime. It's a little bit further away in there. But basically you got horses running around in there. And this spot here looks like a total jungle. The middle of the summer. But now it looks like a... I don't know what this is, but it really looks, doesn't look like the Jurassic Park that it used to look. But you can see that... steel thing in there. It looks like it's some kind of... Like, why is that in even there? It looks like some kind of box to hold Pokemons in or something. But I don't know why is it standing in there. But you can see that this is like the typical kind of mid-winter weather in Finland. There's a shallow icing on that lake thing over there. And then they haven't even used the kind of like some kind of machine to drive the snow off. I don't even know what the English word is once upon a time. I mean, I probably remembered that kind of word, but not anymore. And here's also, here you got this kind of bridge that it's also covered in snow. Yeah, and you can get the snow off like that. And there's, you can see on the other side, that there's also kind of like water down there. Semi-frozen water. And this part is also, this is basically like a lake. It's a small fake lake that's made for birds and animals. Now you might think that it's a field if you don't know. And here on the other side it's blocked by this barrage. So I think this is put in here because it's stopping the elks and other Bambi kind of creatures from running over there and sinking in there. Because they might be stupid enough to do that. They think it's just a field, but they're gonna sink in there, I think. And So when you walk around here in the middle of the summer, this looks very different, and you can get all kind of like ducks and other kind of birds around here. They might be really, what you call it, kekw, kind of like tamed, so that if you give them something like food, like bun, like a bun or bread or something, they might eat it from your hand just by sitting on the, they usually sit on the sides, and then they go swimming there in a kind of like a dungeon party style, and they usually breed there's kind of like these small islands in the middle with those plant stuffs in there, so they, in the summertime you can clearly see a lot of those grass things, kind of like, it really looks like this kind of like a Pokemon hunting zone in the middle of that small lake, or we call it Lampi, which is kind of like a really small, small lake. It's much smaller than a actual lake. But here it also looks like, it looks like you could just run on this, but you're gonna most likely sink, and then you're gonna swim in that peace pool in there, and you can see that there's a lot of that. Hopefully the camera, it's really hard to film this because I have to hold the Umbrella Corporation flag on my hands while I'm trying to avoid the camera from being in too much snowing. That's this little tiny snowing that's kind of like flying sideways. It's not these big snowflakes, but these really tiny things. They're almost like some kind of crystal dust or something. There's some kind of electric plant thing in there on the other side, and it's basically also the reason why it's crossed over like that. And this is the place. I was walking somewhere in here in the last summer, and I actually stepped into a huge dirt pile of shit, and it was like I stepped on it, and it was like it was surrounding my whole shoe. It was around here somewhere. It was like this surprise mine that I stepped on, and I had to go to the local laundry house down there to wash my whole food with soap and stuff. But this is a, if you go and put up the Pokemon Go game on, and this thing here is kind of like a, it looks like some kind of watchtower for some kind of military on medieval times, but it's basically made for checking out birds with binoculars and stuff, because they usually hang out in that place. Now right now I'm thinking that this must be frozen, so if I'm only having one hand, my both hands are covered with something, I might slip and fall, but hopefully that doesn't happen. So I'm gonna try to be a brave dungeon grinder in solo and try to climb up the frozen stairs. Hopefully nothing doesn't happen, please, because you might slip and break your fucking self right here. Yes, so now it basically tells you in Finnish and in olet hyvällä lintupaikalla, you're in a good spot for birds, so I guess you can catch a lot of birds here. These are some of the birds that you can see around here. Suomenlojan lintuallas, that's the place that I'm in, if you wanna spy me on the Google Maps or something. And yes, so this place is also in the Pokemon Go. This is a Pokemon Center, or what is it called? Pokemon, some kind of like a battleground. What was it called? It's been so long time ago that I don't even remember what those things are called. But I used to battle here, right here on this very spot, a couple of summers ago, day with my little brother online. We were party cooping in the same place. And now, yeah, you can see that even those electric wires, they actually go high voltage, Linkin Park style. They're linking the electric wires to the other side, and they go magically over that thing. So it's probably also not a good idea to swim in there if those high voltage wires drop down for some magical reason and barbecue you in there. Because it's gonna do some a lot of electric damage to you if you swim down there while they drop down. But yeah, so now this in the winter time, this place really looks like some kind of there's like some kind of fucking nuclear winter going on down here, so there's no light at all and stuff. It really looks like that. But in summertime, you got a lot of plants growing and birds flying and all that stuff. But now it looks like it's really dead. Winter is usually like that, unfortunately. That occasionally, fuck me, now I need to play in FPS mode and watch out that I don't actually sleep and pull myself into some kind of sleep knot here. But yeah, I'm swimming in the snow. You can see my hand. And okay, so the FPS goal of this dungeon was done correctly now. Okay, I'm snow climbing professional. Also, there's kind of like a summer bench that you can chill out in, and it's also covered all in snow. And nobody cares about if it's covered in snow in the winter time, because I don't think that they take care of this place at all, really. At least it's not much, but you can see that there's a lamp. So they actually got light coming out of those little lamps on the middle of the night. Because it's usually, this is kind of like, it's kind of like you really don't get a lot of light here otherwise, because it's in this really naturey place. So these lamps are gonna help you a lot if you walk in here in the middle of the night. And usually in winter time the nights are a lot darker also. It affects the darkness of the stuff. And here you can see that kind of like, I don't know what pipes they are, but it's part of the factory that's down there. So I was about to, this is the route that I have run over a lot of times by playing Pokemon Go and by trying to raise my fitness and stuff. But last summer I stepped into a huge dirt or poop shit pile, and I don't even know, was it made by some kind of elk, or it might have been made by some kind of animals that around. They are not these home dogs or cats or something. They are some wild animals running around in here. Also like elks and rabbits and foxes. Also I have seen foxes. But I don't know, do even foxes make that big piles of shit? I don't know, they might troll you and do those things. There's some kind of rare spawns that spawn in here in the Pokemon hunting ground. And there you can see half melted you can almost like smell something fishy almost. Yeah, it looks like it's kind of like has this rust color, just like those things up there. So I don't know why is it colored like that. Maybe there's a lot of rotten plants up there, down there, that makes that color. But you're gonna sink in there, because that's basically part of the water pool in there. And now they got a different kind of bridge or wall in here, but it's also made out of metal, so you can't headbang your way through it. Even depending on how metal you are, it's not gonna help you. And there you can see some construction yard in there, or the part of it. I don't know. Can you see the nosturi? But anyway, they're building the metro lines or subway lines usually around there. I think it's ready by now, but they're building also houses next to the subway line here in Espoo. So I'm trying to see. Holy shit! I really. I'm fearing that my cell phone might break down, because it's swimming in so much snow right now. It's really bad for this thing. But if I don't go out right now and film, then I'm never gonna be able to do it. I need to act on instinct, like in Commander Conquer. Okay, so there you can see actually one of the laps is on, so wonder if it's some kind of glitch. But now that it's wind, it's the midday, you can't even see anything. Like it doesn't do anything, but it does help a lot in the middle of the night. So usually it might be somehow glitched, but also if you kick one of those things, then they might break. Once upon a time I also kicked one of those kind of like a things, small lamps, and they broke down. Yeah, you can be a pretty big vandal if you wanna play that kick and punch and stuff game. And there's also, it's surrounded by that kind of shallow garbage river in there. We call it puro. And it's usually made out of this kind of like a, it's not really a river, it's kind of like this excess trash. You can find frogs in those things. Frogs and toads and stuff used to, and also dragonflies, they typically live in those garbage rivers. Yeah, there's going to the some pipe under that kind of like a road down there. I used to play a lot in those kind of places in the, when I was a little kid in the eastern Finland. But now I'm trying to show you some views, but this scene is just so barren, and it looks like shit, man, here compared to the summer. And I'm having difficulties walking here because I'm basically swimming in snow here. You can see that this road here is kind of like it's lifted up from the other place, so that you go here, you can see that it's going down the hill. There's this like this pit on the both side, also in that food in there. Or hood, you can see that the trees are really in that kind of like a pit. And I was about to do one, there's somebody using sauva kävely. So he's basically, he's skiing without the skis on his legs. And my asshole agrees with that. And this, I have no idea, why is this graffiti plank here? What is the purpose of this thing? I have no idea. There might have been something in there. And you can also see that there's a signpost here. But it all powder snowed. So that you can't even see what reads there pretty much. Unless you can speak some good... You can also try to kick it to get the snow off. But it might break the lamp. But you need to know what it says in Finnish. Anyway, I thought to show you something funny from Finland. Hopefully this really only conveys that there's a lot of snow in here. And it's February 20 something of the year 23 or something. Yeah, so when it's summertime, those trees, they have all those trees and plants, they have all those leaves and stuff, so you can't really see. It looks like it's like this huge deep jungle in there behind those things. But now it doesn't really look like it, but the powder snowing does it make it look a little bit thicker. It's like there could be some animals living in some kind of nests or something behind those snow piles somewhere. I'm not sure if this is a popular place to... This might be a little bit too close to some kind of wild animals for humans. The humans might be too close to them and they don't want to live in there. But this place here, these things, they look exactly like the place where you could find Pokemon in the Pokemon games. Especially in summer times. They have this tall grass thing. That's the Commander Kongwer Red Alert building in there. Unit lost. And I also don't want to walk in there because that's most likely also in water. Those might be some kind of semi-water plants that they want to live near or next to water. So this is the path that I was hunting a lot of Pokemon like years ago. I haven't played Pokemon Go in a long time. And I was about to show you something funny, but now I can't really do that funny part because I don't know how to do it without... I'm trying to really avoid getting too wet in the camera part. But this thing is, this is just literally swimming in water, man. It might break down any moment now. But I basically if you happen to watch this video, then you might speed up the video by just like 1.5 times speed or 2 times speed. Speed up the video so it doesn't look so painful and you can still kind of hear what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying. And let's see. That way also there's a couple of new Pokemon spots that you could catch Pokemons. And there's another plank that has no purpose. I don't know what they're doing, but they don't use this path for any kind of skiing regularly. It's not that kind of place where you would have those skiing lines. That in some places you do, but this is basically just a walking path. You can see, yeah, let's keep it steady so that you can kind of the view ratio in this camera is also not really showing the exact view. It's showing a little bit too much zoom. So that view is a little bit closer in your real eyes. It shows it a little bit more distant. It has the kind of like a bad aspect ratio. There's another bench that you can swim in. Somebody wrote love into that bench, I think. And at that place down there is a popular piss break place that I used to go to piss at. And there's a recycling center around that way. And what else was there around here? I'm not sure. But you can get a kind of like a heads up of this place. And what else could I say? Espoo liikkuu. Okay, so there's some kind of workout tag. It looks like some kind of suunnistus sign, but I don't know what's that even called in English. And I'm really getting a peace emergency coming up now, so let me show you what I was about to show you without, if I could have shown it. Let's go to that, it has a, I think we call it heijastin input in the umbrella, but I don't even know what that's called in English. I really suck at the English. But I basically have this package that has some kind of surprise thing in there. Let's see. I'm really getting the pee break feels now. I don't think I can even open it up. Or can I? But anyway, yeah, I think I can. So the funny part is that I would have taken out my Pokemon here with the Pokemon Shiny Vaporeon, and I would have just dragged this thing along while I was walking here. It has the rope on its neck that looks like a slip knot or something, but it's also, I would have made some jokes about having this Pokemon Go creature outside, but now I can't really do it because I'm basically having a huge peace break feels striking me. But let's put the Pokemon in there and let's say good night and thanks for watching and stay tuned for more. Peace out. Let's see what's gonna be the next thing filmed.